The Rehoboth Baster community fear that their culture is threatened by government's failure to acknowledge them as a local indigenous group. Their captaincy is also not recognized by the Namibian constitution as a traditional authority, which stripped them of their rights to ancestral land. Prior to independence, the Baster community lived in harmony in central Namibia, led by chiefs and governed by laws inscribed by their forefathers who first settled in Namibia in the early 19th century. During this period, anyone that wanted to acquire a piece of land would have to approach the chief's council. Young people turning 18 were also accorded a piece of land to call their own. In 1990, everything changed after a municipal council took charge of the town.
In our eyes, this is not a freedom. This really is not freedom. This is oppression. This is genocide. Because if you kill the if you kill the culture and you kill the people, you kill them. That's murder. It's murder of a culture.
A resentful Dentlinger went on to charge that no indigenous group was ever treated in the manner that they were by government.
We had a better deal with South Africa, the apartheid South African regime, than this one here. So, because they recognize our culture, they recognize land ownership. They recognize everything about our culture, the language and all that, and our traditions, which we cannot say about the Namibian government. We cannot say that. We were never part of the independence of Namibia. We never approved that constitution because we have our own.
Dentlinger has no confidence in the current president and less so that his government will improve the situation.
Although he's got the authority to sign executive orders and even declare war if he wants to, but he will not be able to do it on his own. He's controlled by the power forces around him. He will not be able to do that. He will be out of it. He was there out of it once, previously. I don't know what he did, but previously he was sacked as prime minister. And who brought him there? It was the power base.
The old Kaptein's residence, which is considered as a monument locally, is in a dilapidated state. The building was previously used as an administration center by the rulers, which is why it is purposefully located at the hilltop, visible from kilometers away in all directions.
This is the pride of the Rehoboth Baster community. And this is the house that our captain used to receive dignitaries and so on. There were people still looking after the house because there were promises that the first president promised the captain that he will hand over the house for him as an official house to receive people. But it never happened.
We were granted an opportunity to speak to the captain of the Baster people to hear his views on the matter.
En die bewyse is daar dat die regering ons grond gevat het op oneerlike manier is hy gevat. En dit sal ek vir enige iemand sê, want dit is die waarheid. Ek het die bewyse daarvoor. Ons vra niks anders as net ons goed terug en die reg om daardie goed self te bestuur.
McNab succeeded Hans Diergat, who passed away in 1998. The Rehoboth Baster congregation, which represent the group, sent a letter to various high officers, including the president, stating categorically that the Namibian government has no jurisdiction in Rehoboth. 26 years after independence, the group is united and committed towards gaining their sovereignty back. Their captain, however, described the issue as a political problem, which many of his followers failed to understand.